A message to the church, the reasons why America must be judged. 3.6. Having a form of godliness but denying the power of God. According to an ABC NEWS BeliefNet poll, 83% of adults surveyed in the United States identify themselves as Christians. That percentage includes cults such as Mormons and Jehovah's Witnesses. It also includes Catholics, which incorrectly believe that penances, partaking of the Mass, and other works are needed for true salvation, and that Jesus Christ's atonement isn't enough. Nonetheless, America claims to be a Christian nation. But if Americans do not have a personal relationship with Jesus Christ and are not trusting in Him alone for salvation, they are not truly God's children and they do not truly know God. They may do some good deeds or many good deeds, but God sees the hearts of all men and women. He knows those who are His children, and those who profess to be following God and reading the Bibles. If they do not follow the teachings of Christ and the New Testament, they are having a form of godliness, but they are denying the power of God. That means those people are not God's children. 4. Why America cannot be restored except on an individual level. Conclusion. 4.1. America has hardened its heart greatly against God. 4.2. America has defied God every time God has warned it. 4.3. America has chosen to cast God out of its life completely. 4.4. Destruction shall happen because of rebellion. 4.1. America has hardened its heart greatly against God. The process of hardening its heart has been gradual over the course of many generations, but America has become very hardened by the 1970s when abortion was legalized. From 1930 up to 1967, the Hays Code was a standard that guided most Hollywood movies. Before that, movies often promoted blatant immorality since there were no guidelines for what could be shown. During the era of the Hays Code, movies could not portray immorality or anything that was deemed to corrupt the morals of the audience. But times have changed since then and movies have promoted much evil. Things that were unthinkable have been portrayed in R-rated and PG-13 rated movies. But the truth is that Hollywood, even during the years of the Hays Code, did not truly promote what God desires. In the older films, actors and actresses who were not married to each other would kiss each other, which is a form of adultery. Movies during the Hays Code era also portrayed occult powers, immodesty, and things God forbids in His Word. And entertainment itself became an idol for much of America. Of course, today movies are much worse than they were 50 years ago. But that fact does not excuse the evil found in the movies from Hollywood's supposed golden era of film. 4.2. America has defied God every time God has warned it. God has been calling out to this country for a long time. I believe the Vietnam War, economic problems, the attacks on the World Trade Center, the 2008 financial collapse, storms, hurricanes, earthquakes, floods, severe weather, and many other events were allowed by God to happen in order to get America's attention. The Great American Eclipse of 2017 was followed by Texas, Florida, and Puerto Rico being hit by powerful hurricanes. And the eclipse was followed by record-breaking fires and flooding in California. Also, the largest shooting in U.S. history took place in Las Vegas. Months later, record-breaking cold weather has reached much of the mainland U.S. during the winter of 2017-2018. Further ominous signs have appeared. North Korea is threatening to nuke the US and is preparing a nuclear missile which can reach the continental United States. Not long after North Korea's threat to nuke the US, Hawaii experienced a strange false alarm of an incoming missile threat. To make matters worse, Russia and China are very unhappy with this country and have prepared for the possibility of war with America. But have the majority of Americans turned back to God after all this? They haven't. 4.3. America has chosen to cast God out of its life completely. Since America has chosen to reject God's warnings and pleadings to turn back to Him, America will face destruction on a scale never seen before. North Korea has expressed their desire to turn the mainland of the United States into ashes and darkness, McCurry. In September 2017, the North Korean government issued a statement which included this threat. Let's reduce the US mainland into ashes and darkness. Let's vent our spite with mobilization of all retaliation means which have been prepared till now, McCurry. Will North Korea be able to carry out the threat? Or will other nations attack America and destroy it? Or will North Korea and other nations destroy this country? God has shown many people that a host of nations will attack and destroy America because of its great wickedness and because it is rebelling against God. 4.4. Destruction shall happen because of rebellion. Because America has forsaken God and His ways, God will allow America's enemies to conquer and destroy it. That is sadly what shall have to happen. There are some scripture verses which reveal what shall happen to America. Deuteronomy chapter 28 verse 15 says, But it shall come to pass, if thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe to do all His commandments and His statutes which I command thee this day, that all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee. Deuteronomy chapter 28 verse 18 says, Cursed shall be the fruit of thy body, and the fruit of thy land, the increase of thy kind, and the flocks of thy sheep. Deuteronomy chapter 28 verses 20 to 25 says, The Lord shall send upon thee cursing, vexation, and rebuke in all that thou settest thine hand unto for to do, until thou be destroyed, and until thou perish quickly because of the wickedness of thy doings, whereby thou hast forsaken me. 21. The Lord shall make the pestilence cleave unto thee until he have consumed thee from off the land, whither thou goest to possess it. 22. The Lord shall smite thee with a consumption, and with a fever, and with an inflammation, and with an extreme burning, and with the sword, and with blasting, and with mildew, and they shall pursue thee until thou perish. 23. And thy heaven that is over thy head shall be brass, and the earth that is under thee shall be iron. 24. The Lord shall make the rain of thy land powder and dust. From heaven shall it come down upon thee, until thou be destroyed. 25. The Lord shall cause thee to be smitten before thine enemies. Thou shalt go out one way against them, and flee seven ways before them, and shalt be removed into all the kingdoms of the earth. 26. And thy carcase shall be meat unto all fowls of the air, and unto to the beasts of the earth, and no man shall fray them away. End quote. Friends, if we have sin in our lives, we need to repent from it and turn back to God. 1 John chapter 1 verse 9 and 1 John chapter 1 verse 7 and Matthew chapter 4 verse 17 give us the answer for how to deal with sin. Matthew chapter 4 verse 17, For that time Jesus began to preach and to say, Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. 1 John chapter 1 verses 9 to 10, 9, If we confess our sins, He is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Not sinned, we make Him a liar, and His word is not in us. 1 John chapter 1 verses 5 to 8 says, 5. This then is the message which we have heard of Him, and declare unto you, that God is light, and in Him is no darkness at all. 6. If we say that we have fellowship with Him, and walk in darkness, we lie, and do not the truth. 7. But if we walk in the light, as He is in the light, we have fellowship one with another, and the blood of Jesus Christ His Son cleanseth us from all sin. 8. If we say that we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. End quote. America as a whole won't be restored, but individuals certainly can be. Turning to God, who is the light, will bring us deliverance from the devil's snares and freedom from the power of sin. God greatly desires to know us in a personal way and be our personal best friend. Let us seek to know Him and forsake the ways of this world. By depending on God's Holy Spirit and on the Holy Scripture, we will overcome the devil's snares.